In the summer of 2015, I rescued a 12-year-old sorrel mare that I named Fleur from a kill buyer. A kill buyer is a man or woman who goes to the auction and buys cheaper unwanted horses to sell them to Canada or Mexico to ship them over for slaughter. This experience that I had saving her life was life-changing. I drove 6 hours both ways with a group of friends to Fort Scott, Kansas. The environment that Fleur was in was unsanitary, and the horses that were there were packed into small pens. Some were sick, some were starving to death, and some had so many flies on them that they couldn't even see as they stood there with their heads hanging low. Today, I would like to present an unusual subject known as horse slaughter by explaining why and when horse slaughter was outlawed and how we come up with a solution to let horse slaughter happen in the United States again. To start off, let's give you guys a little bit of background on horse slaughter, including when it was banned. The ball began rolling toward the ban of using horse meat for human consumption in California when they passed Proposition 6, which banned the slaughter of horses, donkeys, and mules. Then on September 20, 2005, Senator John Ensign, who was a veterinarian, and 9 other co-sponsors proposed a companion amendment. This amendment proposed prohibition to the use of appropriate federal funds to help pay the salaries or expenses of personnel to inspect horses and horse meat under certain authority or guidelines. Commercial horse slaughter today is banned in America, but personal use of horse slaughter is not, meaning that if you want to slaughter your horse, you can do that. In 2007, the last horse slaughter plant was closed in DeKalb, Illinois. Horse slaughter was banned in the United States because the American public pushed that horses are companion animals. A companion animal is known as a domesticated or domestic bred animal whose physical, emotional, behavioral, and social needs are met in the home or in close relationship with humans. But horses are working livestock. They have a job and a purpose, whether it be from helping move and sort cattle to merely taking care of a senior citizen or child lazily down a trail. The American Veterinarian Medical Association, or the AVMA, stated that removing slaughter as a humane option will leave many horses with nowhere to go and no one to take care of them, which means that they are likely to be acute to a rise in abuse, neglect, abandonments, with corresponding negative impacts on the overall horse welfare. Now, where do these unwanted horses go now that there isn't slaughter in the United States? Horses either go to horse rescues and sanctuaries, or they go to the auction to be sold by kill buyers. Horse rescues and sanctuaries are already at or near capacity all throughout the United States. According to the Unwanted Horse Coalition's 2009 survey, 63% of equine rescues and facilities reported that they are at or near capacity, and on average, they turn away 38% of the horses brought to them. With this being said, shipping horses sometimes for more than 24 hours across the country to Canada or Mexico packed onto cattle trailers exceeding humane numbers on a trailer with no rest, water, or food is just one of the worst outcomes that many horses can have. The longer rides for these horses will have increased potential for inhumane treatment after they have crossed the borders to go into Canada or Mexico to be slaughtered. According to the USDA, however, nearly 100,000 equines were exported from the U.S. to Mexico and Canada in 2009 for slaughter. Then the number increased to over 100,000 in 2009 and nearly 120,000 in 2010.
Okay. Okay, so. Is crammed on the two.
The video that I am showing you will be able to give you an idea on how the horses are inhumanely shipped over thousands of miles to their final destination. These horses in the video are transported from all the way from Ohio to Mexico with no rest, food, or water on the trailers that they are illegal. Okay, these trailers that they are in are actually cattle trailers, and it is illegal to ship horses in a double-decker trailer. So. Just gives you a look on how they're smashed into a trailer. Thank you. members of Congress on the issue of unwanted horses that is going on in the United States, urging them to develop a viable solution for this unwanted problem. The suggestion solution is disposing unwanted horses that cannot be placed in rescues. The ABAM recommends slaughter. This is not any different than having dogs and cats in the animal shelters that have to be put down because they cannot be cared for. The only difference is that horses are livestock. By providing horse slaughter facilities, this will help the humane justice for horses as well as helping out the United States economy. Southern Illinois University conducted a study reviewing the economic impacts of horse slaughter in the United States. Their study showed that the economy collapsed in the horse world when slaughterhouses for horses closed in the United States. This was due to the removal of effective price floors established by the slaughterhouses. This price shift affected the equity built in horses, whether it be from breeding or showing them. The assertion is also made that the ban of horse slaughter not only led to immediate negative impact on the horse industry, but also a perpetual increase in the expense associated with the disposal costs of unwanted horses. It is further pointed out that there is no provision for the increased spending for care of unwanted horses by the Humane Society facilities. This graph behind me shows the decline in horse prices. The darker purple is the average before slaughter, and then the lighter purple is the average price after. Bringing back horse slaughter will not only help our economy thrive by creating jobs in the United States, but it also helped the horse market and world get back on their feet and make a statement back into our economy. Along with horses being slaughtered for meat, we will gain money by exporting the meat to the foreign countries. With the horse slaughter thriving and horses gaining the humane treatment they are entitled to, we will be able to provide pros to both sides of the debate. Now let's see how much it costs to own and take care of a horse year-round. On average, it costs about $2,200 to feed one horse per year. Vet bills is about $100 with shots, unless something happens and your horse gets hurt, and then it could be a lot more. The farrier that takes care of your horse's hooves costs about $60 just to have them trimmed, but it'd be about $100 to have shoes on if you're doing something with them. So that total cost added up to $2,780 on average. Taking care of your horse per year can cost up to $20,780 for average. If horses were treated as livestock, they would not be as wanted due to the money that is involved. Livestock such as cows, pigs, chickens are well taken care of because of the money that is involved in them. With very little money involved in horses now, it leads to people sending horses to auction and kill buyers purchasing them and shipping them to Mexico. The well-being of the humane treatment of horses is what is really at stake right now. Most of America probably sees horse slaughter as something that is inhumane to the horses, but in reality, horse slaughter would end up saving them because in the United States, we'd be able to regulate how they are treated, but while in Mexico or Canada, once the horses are over the border, we do not have a say in the matter. As you can see, what I have shared with you today has helped put some light on who is really at risk of being caused inhumane justice. If you'd like to sign a petition that is being sent to Congress, here's the link, or I can email it to you. But thank you for listening. Thank you.